Hello and welcome everyone. Today we are going to learn about the role-based authorization, with the learning outcome being we shall learn about role-based authorization in ASP.NET Core 3. Now ASP.NET Core 3 is in the preview 7, so that is what it is applicable to, how role checks are added in the code. So let's switch over to the actual slide. So a created identity may belong to one or more roles. Now a person's name Jack may belong to the user role, whereas another person Jill may belong to both administrator and user roles. Now the backing store, here by backing store, I guess the Microsoft people mean that it is the backend process, you know, backend code or the entire system in place as a backup for the authorization logic, and that determines how these roles are created and managed. Okay, so the isInRole method on the claims principle class exposes the roles to the developer. Now adding role checks, there is a role-based authorization checks are always declarative. And by declarative, it means that the developer embeds them within their code. The code embedding is done against a controller or an action within the controller. The code specifies the roles which the current user must be a member of to access the required requested resources. Now everything will be clear with a piece of code, so please be patient. Now here, this is a snippet of a code of administration controller class, which derives from the controller in MVC. So on the top there is an authorized attribute with roles as administrator. Now this code limits access to any actions on the administration controller to users who have administrator role. Okay, so any user who has got the administrator role can have the access to the entire controller and all its action methods. So now there is another piece of code here. Now here we are putting the authorized attributes with roles HR manager and finance. So a member who has got the HR manager role and the or the finance role, this is or, so has got access to the salary controller. Now we can specify multiple roles, that's what it is, as a comma separated list. Here is a comma separated list. Okay, so the code snippet here ensures that the salary controller can only be accessed by members of the HR manager role or the finance role. Okay, so either or, so this is a comma separated list of multiple roles. But here, this is, you know, we can apply multiple attributes to a controller. So we have got authorized roles as power user and authorized roles as control panel user. But here, this is the AND clause is valid. In this case, an accessing user must be a member of all the roles specified. So a member should be a role of a power user as well as a control panel user to access the control panel controller. Okay, so now here is another piece of code which says that authorized attribute is applied for members of administrator and power user. So the control panel class or the control panel controller is accessible by members of the administrator and power user class. However, for the shutdown action or shutdown action method, you need to have only the administrator role. So we can further limit access by applying additional role of authorization attributes at the action level. So at the action level, when we are putting a authorized attribute with a role as administrator, then the members of the administrator role or the power user can access the controller and the set time action, but not the shutdown action, because only members of the administrator role can access the shutdown action. Okay, and not the members of the power user. So it is again restricting at the action level. Now there is another piece of code here which has got allow anonymous attribute. Now we can also lock down a controller, meaning ensure the authorization is required for access to the controller through this authorize attribute at the class level or the controller level. However, if you have put a allow anonymous attribute to the login action, then anybody or unauthenticated users can also access this action, individual action, which is login in this case. For razor pages, the authorize attribute can be applied to the page model instance. So when you put like that, authorize policy equals require administrator role, and we have got an instance of page model, update model. So authorize attribute. So before ending the lecture today, we have learned in this tutorial about the role-based authorization in ASP.NET Core 3 and how role checks are added in code.